Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Successful Software Projects. Today, we're going to answer a couple of questions, and thank you all for these great questions that you have given us. Here is Tomas Soroka.
And Diana Mantivara.
And we had a great presentation here in Luxembourg about behavior-driven development. And after that, we put it also in SlideShare and got a lot of interesting questions. So this is a Q&A session for your questions around. And coming to the first question already, during the event, we got a question already from Luxembourg. So we're going to state it in the beginning.
And in the city.
In the city, yeah. Yes. So there's a question from Paul, who's a CEO here in Luxembourg. He said that, or questioned us, we have started an IT project which is not delivering as it should. How could I take behavior-driven development into my already started software project?
Okay, very, very good question. So thank you, Paul.
Yeah, Paul.
Thank you, Paul, yes. So what can you do? Yeah, it's of course, if your project is not going as expected, or this what is delivered is not this what you expected, then of course there can be many reasons. Yeah, so the most important is to find them. From my expertise, from my experience, is that they might be around requirements and acceptance criteria. So it means that probably developers who are delivering the project, the application, are not giving you exactly what you wanted. Yeah. So one of good approaches is to use Gherkin language, a bit of BDD, behavior-driven development, and start describing your requirements in the sense that they will become our acceptance criteria, and this will be the way how to validate this what you expect and what is given to you. Yeah, and then if you will write it down properly, then in next iterations, next versions, it will be very good way to validate if this what is delivered is this what you expected.
So you were talking about Gherkin language. What's Gherkin? Tell us.
Gherkin is a language used in behavior-driven development, and it's a very simple thing. This is the way how we describe requirements and acceptance criteria in human language. In most cases, we use English language, and in Gherkin, we have some important phrases like given, when we describe context, user context. Then we have word when, so we describe what user is doing, and then, so this is an action, what should happen in some specific moment. For example, we have mobile application login screen, and we can have such scenario like given anonymous user is on our login screen in application, and this is our context.
Okay.
Then we have word when, so when user will put his credentials, login and password into boxes, then trigger after clicking login button should be logged in into application. Yeah, and what is very interesting, of course this is very simple scenario, mm-hmm. but what is interesting and important, you can see that for client, for tester, for developer, this description is easy to understand in the same way.
Even yeah? For business people.
Exactly. And okay. this is the very big value in Gherkin. Yeah.
Yeah.
And it is simple form, so it's simple to write down, simple to put in your documentation properly, and also do some kind of automatization. Yeah, because this is also part of BDD, but let's leave it because it's, let's say, more advanced way. So
okay.
We start from simple okay. things.
Okay, second question. Actually, we have four questions in total. So this is the second question coming. And this comes from Mark. Mark is project manager, IT project manager in London.
Wow, nice.
And he's a question regarding the BDD framework. So he's asking, is BDD just for testing?
No, this is one of the biggest mistakes people do in their thinking, that BDD is a part of test-driven development, and that it is the way how to describe test-driven test, how this test should be prepared. No, BDD is something, of course it's connected with TDD, mm-hmm. but this is the whole approach to developing software. Yeah, and the main advantage of BDD mm-hmm. is that BDD is the way how we communicate, how all stakeholders are communicating in the project. So we have, we call it ubiquitous language.
Yeah.
So the way how we communicate, and that we communicate in the same way. And of course, as I said before, it is connected with TDD, but this is not a subpart of TDD or anything like this. So this is much wider, and it should be used on different levels, not only on testing level, but on requirements collecting level, preparing architecture, then validating acceptance criteria. Mm-hmm. So there is a lot of things in.
Okay, that's quite clear. So then,
thank you.
Question three, coming from Sweden, Malmö. Lisa is a program manager in her company. And she's asking, how can BDD help writing down acceptance criteria?
This is a very good question. And I can answer how we do it in Liwer, in our company. So the typical approach, if people use it, because now we have agile methodologies, agile approach, everyone is using user stories. Hopefully for everyone here it's clear what user story is. If not, let us know, we will do maybe some movie and we will explain it. But people describe their requirements as user stories, and of course in this Agile manifesto we have also description that we should have acceptance criteria. Yeah, so acceptance criteria is the explanation when we know that user story is implemented as expected. Yeah, but not too many people think about it. Yeah, and here if we use BDD approach, mm-hmm. then we have connection between two things: user story and scenarios, which are examples. Yeah, we also sometimes call it that we have documentation done by using scenarios, and each scenario which described the specific case is our requirement, but also is our acceptance criteria. So in the moment when we start validating if this what is developed is this what we really needed, mm-hmm. we just go through all scenarios, we read them, or if they are automatized we just execute them and see if this what is delivered is this what was described here. Yeah, okay. And this is and what is good that this is, as I said in the question, as you remember, number one, mm-hmm. We use some formal language, Gherkin, so it's easy to follow, and we have one way of writing down acceptance criteria.
Okay, that's clear for everybody. Then there is the fourth and the last question coming from Bordeaux, France. This is Xavier. Xavier is a just a moment. Xavier is actually a mobile app developer, Scrum Master in his project. And he's asking where I should store BDD scenarios.
Very good question. Very, very good question. And this is also wider question. And in general, the question is how and where should we store documentation for the project? There is many approaches. The simple is, for example, Word file, but then we can have huge document. Mm-hmm. Many people use wikis like Confluence or wiki included in Microsoft environment, Microsoft tools for developers. But always the question is, what happens with documentation which is needed? Of course, what should be included in documentation, but what happens during time? Yeah, and this what we saw many, many times is that in most cases there is no documentation because we use agile approach, so we just start coding and delivering, and it's great. It's very agile, and we can have MVP after 300-500 hours or even faster, and everyone is happy. But the question is, what will happen after 1 year of such development? I can assure you, if you are very, very agile, then you can be, you can easily find yourself in situation that you have no documentation, the code is not easy to read, and if you will try to switch one developer to another, it will be problematic. Or if you will want to switch one team to another, then in many cases they will answer you, sorry, but this code is a piece of spaghetti, you need to rewrite from scratch. So documentation is important, but the question is, what should be included in documentation, because we shouldn't produce hundreds of pages of something what no one will read, and the documentation should be synchronized with the code during the time. So it shouldn't be like that we have something in the beginning, but after 3 months of development, we finished our first version of product, but it's a bit different than documentation which was prepared in the beginning. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and here BDD can help, and our approach in Lewer, and I think that this is the best one, is to store BDD documentation in Git repository.
Okay. And tell about what's that? Probably business people don't understand what's Git repository.
So Git repository is a standard for storing the code.
Okay.
And the biggest advantage is that it can be, code can be easy, we can easily track all changes. We can have forks, branches, so it's easy to manage complicated projects this way. Okay. Yeah, especially when more than one developer is developing our solution, and we have the same approach to store documentation. Yeah, so we can see what was changed when, from what to what, so it's easy to track all changes or changing requirements and so on and so on. We can easily branch our documentation and, for example, have version of documentation for version 1.x of our product and then for version 2.x. So it gives us many more possibilities to control the whole project. And maybe in the beginning it looks quite complicated or strange, but I saw it many, many times, and our clients as well, that this is one of the best ways to store documentation. So thank you. What was the name of the guy?
Xavier.
Thank you, Xavier, for this question, because it's very, very good question, and this is very, very important topic.
Okay. Hey, thank you. That was the four questions we wanted to answer to you. Please send us new questions as well. We'll do our best answering you, all of them. And we'll stay in touch. We'll be doing this more, and you'll be seeing more of our videos as well. Thank you.
And I would like to add that please put comments. Yeah, we love discussions. So if you have different point of view or would like to ask anything else, leave a comment, subscribe us, yeah?
Yeah, sure.
If you like us, do like this. If not, do like that. And that's it.
They will love us, yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.